Legrand, 6'2", 275-pound junior from Avenel, New Jersey.
The weather was perfect for football. There was 5 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Running down on the field and going down there to make a tackle in a big game, just like I've done hundreds of times before.
Oh, what a great open field hit by Eric Legrand, who is shaken up on the play.
It felt like a flash grenade went off. Everything went silent in slow motion for a minute, and then all of a sudden I was on the ground. And I tried to get up and I couldn't move. And I was just sitting there like, what's going on? I can't breathe right now. And then I just blacked out. And they explained the whole thing. You fractured your C3, C4 vertebrae, and you were paralyzed. So I'll never be able to come off the ventilator. Never be able to eat solid foods. Never be able to walk again. They told me I'll never be able to live a normal life. Almost 10% of my life has been in this chair.
Take his arm out of the harness.
You got an itch on your face, you just scratch it. Now I look at my, I gotta call somebody. Basically, I'm fighting a war that I don't know is gonna end. And that's the hardest thing right there.
Eric Legrand is on a mission to create a new life for himself. Faced with obstacles most would deem insurmountable, his notion of winning and losing has truly taken on a different meaning.
Push, come on.
But where others might see despair, he sees hope. 2 years ago, Eric's life changed forever. And today, he is a new kind of warrior.
I really believe that this happened for a reason. I'm supposed to do great things with this situation.
Inspiring others everywhere and fighting for a future he can see just over the horizon.
You see, I'm defeating the odds and I'm breathing on my own, traveling all over the United States, doing just amazing things.
Shift right, left foot forward.
And I just gotta keep on fighting, set standards high for many other people out there, and really make them believe in themselves too.
If we're lucky, if we have the courage and the strength, maybe we can embrace our destinies. Each day, Eric Legrand fights beyond measure to embrace his, and there is one final battle he is determined to win.
And when I'm done with my time, it's over to inspire everybody. I believe I will walk again. And when I do rise from this.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Eric Legrand.
Start off by thanking the people that help me every day, like my mom, my family, my nurses, all my friends, and the people at Kessler Institute over in West Orange, New Jersey, that are getting me to where I want to get to and that's back up on my feet. You know, on October 16, 2010, I never thought anything like that would happen to me. I'm running down the field to make that tackle in the fourth quarter, and boom, next thing you know, I'm laying on the ground. I didn't know if I was going to die there or not. You know, felt like I got the wind knocked out of me. Couldn't move or anything. I went to try to get up and I just couldn't move. The next thing you know, I have Coach Shiano on my face just saying, you gotta pray, Eric. And I was just like, what's going on? What am I praying for? Is this the end of it? Is this going to be the end of my life right here? And all of a sudden, you know, all these trainers and everyone are running up to me. And I'm just like, is it your head or your neck? And I told them, I can't breathe. And I started freaking out. But, you know, I started praying like Coach Yama told me to. And the stretcher came out. They lifted me up on the stretcher. And all of a sudden, I just caught a gasp of air. And I knew right there that, all right, this is time. This is going to be a battle. I don't know what's going on with me right now. But I know I'm just going to have to fight through it. And as they brought me on the stretcher and I saw my mom freaking out, I told her everything's going to be okay. They put me in the ambulance and I blacked out. It was a Saturday. Don't remember anything until Wednesday. Woke up on Wednesday, saw my mom and my girlfriend in the room. Asked my mom, I was like, Mom, don't worry about anything. I'm going to be okay. I'll be back. Asked my girlfriend, actually, will she help me walk again? She said yes. And ever since then, it's been a battle. It's been a grind, you know. People ask me, how do I stay so motivated every single day of my life? And it's all the people that tweet me, I read it on my Twitter or my Facebook every day. Or when I go to therapy every day, I see people fighting for the same battle that I'm fighting for to get back on their feet. Those are the unsung heroes that no one else gets to see, that I, you know, that I'm trying to be the leader of and help get a, you know, cure for this injury. That's going through Team Walk. Everybody out there that's doing so many amazing things with spinal cord research, I'm trying to help encourage everyone out there. You know, we need the funds for it because there's so many people in this world that are in wheelchairs through spinal cord injuries that people don't know about. But, you know, I'm trying to be that leader and help everyone out because everyone wants to fight for that same goal and get back on their feet. But I have a few friends I want to mention that I met at Kessler that changed my life forever. You know, when I first got hurt, I had so much support. All the letters, everyone writing letters to me, coming in to visit me, lines outside of my door for people to come see me. But then I have my two friends, Jermaine and Mike, over there at Kessler, and they have nobody there for them. The mothers, family, no one's coming to see them, maybe once or twice a month. So I took them into my family, bring them into my room, you know, hang out with everybody. You know, my one friend, Jermaine, unfortunately, he had cancer in his spine, and it ended up spreading to his brain, and then his family wanted to come and support him. And I was just like, you know, see, this is why I appreciate everything that I do have in my life, because he died last June. And, you know, I was just like, you know, I have everything that I want in my own life right now. All the support. I can do anything that I want to do. Even though I'm sitting in this chair, it may not be the circumstance that I want. But I'm going out there trying to inspire all the people to live to the best of your abilities. Don't forget anything that you have. Don't take anything for granted. Because in 1 second, it can be all thrown away. 15 years of my life, I've been training to go to NFL. That was my dream. Now you see me sitting here in this chair, and my dream is to get back on my feet and walk again and inspire millions of people out there in this world to don't take anything for granted and be the best person that you could be. Coach Yano picked me up to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, made my dream come true. You know, that was just a great gesture that him and the whole organization did. And I'm proud to say that I'm part in the NFL. May not be where I want to be, not be able to play it down, but I can see that I made it there. And it's honestly truly a blessing that everything that has happened in my life. And like Jimmy V always said, don't give up, don't ever give up. You can best believe that I'll never get up and I will rise from this chair. And I'm going to be walking all over this world, dancing, having a great time. And I just want to thank you all again for listening to me.